and welcome. You're watching Head to Head. I'm Antonina Antosha with UATV. The British Council in Ukraine continues its commitment to improving the professional skills of retired military officers by providing an English language course as part of the Ukraine-NATO program. It aims at easing the post-war social adaptation of ex-military. To talk more about the course, we welcome to our studio today Christopher Holmes. He's the Director of Teaching for Ukraine and Georgia at British Council. So, hello and thank you for joining us.
Hello, thanks for the opportunity.
Let's talk about the course.
Okay. Well, as you've just very clearly explained there, this is part of the NATO resettlement program. Mm-hmm. And the NATO resettlement program involves training in lots and lots of different skills, helping retired military personnel back into civilian life and into employment. Our particular course is clearly focused on the teaching of English. I think it offers a lot more than purely the teaching of English, but that's ultimately the goal. The idea over 4 months, 5 days a week, 5 hours a day, is to support and very quickly, in an immersive fashion, help people rapidly improve their English so that they become more employable, mm-hmm. and are able to get the kind of employment that they desire.
So has the course been launched already?
So these courses have been going on since the year 1999 or 2000. I'm not absolutely sure of that, but yes, they have been going on for a very long time.
Especially for ex-military men.
Exactly. Yes, we've been teaching. We've been teaching here and had a presence since 1990. But in terms of working with NATO,
was the same schedule, right?
Some changes and different iterations over time. Mm-hmm. A number of those are in relation to eligibility, and also I think the starting level of English that different military personnel have now compared with how they might have been 20 years ago. Mm-hmm. But basically it's a similar program that has been funded by NATO, and we are one of their partners, and we've been doing that for a long time.
What about the number of those who are willing to become the students of this program or this course? Has it grown comparing to, let's say, the period before the year 2014?
Okay. I would say yes. I don't have any hard data to prove that, but we have no end of applicants. In fact, we continually receive applications. Our application process is always open, and it's just a case of how many courses can we put on and how many courses will be funded by NATO. So these are our kind of restrictions. We typically do 2 or 3 courses a year, most typically in Kiev. Mm-hmm. However, we also do courses in Kharkiv, and we have delivered courses in other cities as well.
How many students are there in one course usually?
14 or 15. Mm. That's kind of ideal for a learning environment. Mm-hmm. We can't go much more than that. And clearly, in terms of value for money, it's quite important that we have a decent sized number of people on the course.
What about the evaluation process for the applicants? Do you have any criteria that the applicants have to actually fulfill in order to be admitted to the course?
Well, I would say that the criteria is more about eligibility and how one qualifies, and this is laid down by NATO, so it's not necessarily something that we have a lot of say in. But if I can explain a little bit, for those that want to take part, and I obviously have written this down, people need to have served either in the Ministry of Defence or in the National Guard, or the State Border Guard, or the Security Service of Ukraine. And they need to either be actively serving and coming to the end of their contract, or they need to have finished within the last 3 years of the start date of the course. One other important thing is that they need to have the time and clearly the motivation to make the most of the course, because of course the money is being funded through NATO. It's quite important that they see results, and therefore it's quite important that people
How do you check the results?
Well, the results are ultimately followed up upon by NATO, and in fact the NATO resettlement program. This is a key part of what the NATO offer is. It's not just about military, it's about supporting people following military conflict and so on. And so what we know is that approximately 80% of the people that come on the course do indeed find employment in a job that they are happy with.
Mm-hmm. Maybe you have some kind of a personal story of one of the ex-students of the course that you would like to share. And what I mean right now is mm-hmm. that the student actually got a job or was employed somewhere where he really wanted to and couldn't obtain this position because of the lack of the knowledge of the English language. And after completing the course, mm-hmm. he was able to do it, he yeah. or she.
I have a few examples.
Please share.
I think what's interesting for me is the kind of employment that people find following the course. So quite recently we invited back a number of people that were ex-graduates of the course, and mm-hmm. we caught up with them and tried to understand what it was that they were doing. So we had somebody that was now working for the Ministry of Infrastructure. We have someone who works for the Motor Insurance Bureau of Ukraine. We have someone who works in the Museum of Aviation, but we also have someone who works as a business development director in a private aviation company. But I think the story that I would like to share with you is one involving perhaps you even have heard of her. Her name is Maya Moscovich. And what she did following the course, so she studied with us in 2018, and following the completion of her course, she then went to represent Ukraine at the Invictus Games in Sydney, Australia. Mm-hmm. This was again in the summer of 2018, and she won a gold medal for Ukraine
Yay.
In the sport of archery. And what difference the course has made in this particular case is that on winning the course, of course, now she can speak English, so she can talk to journalists and she can talk about the situation within Ukraine, mm-hmm. And she can do that with a good degree of confidence. And I think that this is clearly an important thing for Ukraine to be able to raise awareness of the situation that is here.
Speaking of the situation that mm-hmm. is happening in the east of Ukraine, it's been going on for almost 5 years now. Has that had any impact or any effect on the courses that, as you have mentioned, have been going on starting in 1999, wow. so for 20 years now?
Well, I mean, as we've already discussed, I suppose to some extent there are more people that are interested in the course as there are, you know, interest in mm-hmm, retraining mm-hmm. because there are more and more people that have been involved in some way in that conflict. I mentioned earlier two types of eligibility. There is a third one, which is for former servicemen and women who have retired for more than 10 years, but then were mobilized back into the ATO zone,
uh-huh.
they also are eligible for the training. So from that point of view, definitely. Whether there are further differences, I couldn't be sure.
Do you give out certificates to your graduates?
Yes, of course. And I think that's something that they value. Mm. But possibly not as much as some of the other things that they benefit from in terms of the course. So, of course, there's the English itself.
What else?
There's the certificate. But what I have found through talking with both present participants and with graduates is that what they benefit from the course goes beyond that. It includes the camaraderie that they gain from working with one another in something that's quite intensive. They have a support network, so once they finish the course, they typically stay in contact with one another. And I think they benefit from going back to an environment of some kind of normality, having been in a conflict zone, to coming back to the relative mundanity of a classroom and be enjoying studying English seems so normal, and I think that can help reintegrate them back into a kind of a civilian life that you or I would recognize.
That was actually the question I wanted to ask next. So maybe, just maybe, apart from being an opportunity to improve or learn English, this is also some kind of therapy for ATO veterans that are coming from the front line, because they do need help while getting back to normal civilian life. So making connections, creating a helpful network, as you have said, and on top of that, as a bonus, improving English language skills, that is just amazing. Do you plan to increase in future? What are your future plans?
Well, to continue doing what we're doing, and obviously we don't have total control over the number of courses that we're doing. That has to come down to NATO funding. Yeah. They pay for the course, we provide the service. So we would love to continue doing it. We have a present contract that sees us doing two or three courses up through to the end of 2020. Mm-hmm. But typically after two or three years, we need to re-tender for that contract with NATO and mm-hmm. to prove that we are and remain the best service provider that NATO can choose from.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm sure you are. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you very much.
That was Christopher Holmes. He is the Director of Teaching for Ukraine and Georgia at British Council. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned with UATV for more.